I pulled out Claire's medical records before working out what I was going to say. My back's just about recovered from the power issue. I look back and I think you've been one of mine since 2008 when I first started, but with us for a bit longer than that even. And looking through my letters, we talk about lots of medical stuff, which is a bit dull, but we also talked about how Claire was, and we talked about how her family was. My clinic's quite often overrun a little bit because we waffle on about other stuff. And looking through, what became apparent was Claire's mood was dropping. We quite often had a hypo count and a paramedic call-out count, which was 4 or 5 times a week. And then Claire came along and said, could I fill in this form? Because she was going to get a dog which would help with her diabetes. And I thought, well, this seems a bit strange, but I think having dogs in a house are good anyway. Well, we'll see what happens. I'll fill in whatever I had to say. And I wrote in the letter subsequently, in October, so you've got the dog, I think, in July, and in October, having all my letters documented, not getting out, actually she talked about you boys, worried about getting home, what they were going to find when they got home from school, not wanting to leave mum. And the first thing in the letter, when I saw you after Pal had come home after the training, was she has been transformed. And it's been incredible. And actually you told me the story of going to the Kent County show not long after you'd had Pal. And I won't forget that you said, I still wasn't quite sure how all this worked and the science behind it, because we like stats and a bit of the science. And you said that somebody else had come to the stand at the show and Pal wouldn't leave him alone. And eventually you twigged, are you diabetic? Can you check your sugar? And sure enough, this chap who'd never met Pal before had a very low blood sugar. So Pal was already working not just with Claire, but with anybody else with low blood sugars to detect it. And it was slightly mind-blowing, actually, for a slightly dubious doctor who didn't really understand the science behind all this. And since then, Claire's moved on to dialysis, and Pal comes to dialysis. And Claire always moans about Pal coming to dialysis, because Pal gets all the attention, and Claire doesn't get any. I moan about Pal coming to dialysis, because he leans against me when I'm trying to talk to Claire, and makes my feet a bit too hot. But he has made an overwhelming difference, I think, to Claire, and we've heard to her family. And actually, he's made quite a difference to our dialysis unit, because everybody loves seeing Pal. Dogs, whether they're medical or not, bring a smile to people's faces. And it's been incredible. I suspect the paramedics are quite pleased that they don't have to find their way to your house very often anymore as well. So, all in all, Pal has been amazing. Not just for Claire and her family, but I think for all of us in our dialysis unit in Maidstone, he's been a fantastic asset. Opened my eyes to the possibilities of what dogs can do. So, brilliant. And well done.